All right, we're back with episode 11. Coming off our first game yet, our first loss of the season. Got sacked like 7 times. What kind of advice you didn't give me? Dude, we just need a better offensive line. Pass rush. Yes. That's good. Need that. All right, we're playing the Titans. So we can come out with a dub. Let's go. Can't be any worse than last game, right? He must have turned it over. Or just had a really good punt. Oh, Lindsay's back. Let's go. Yep. Yay. Great start. Throw it! Throw it! Throw it! Oh, my lord. It wouldn't let me throw the ball. I was holding X. Wow. Alright. Come on, man. You gotta block that.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
Now this one to his running back. Good that we got Lindsay back. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because they're ready to make people miss in the open field.
Looking at an accurate throw with a probably got the first. Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. On play action, they'll throw. Flush to his right. Let's go. Apart from Kyler Murray, not too many mobile QBs in this year's rookie class, but some good. I've heard that same commentary so many times. Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier on this drive. Yeah, and so now two times this has happened. Do you adjust something? Yeah, I think you do. I think you have something about your running range. Try not to get too wide or too narrow. Second longer. All we needed. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. And this passing game's whole offense really didn't show up in the loss last week, and it hasn't started all that great. There we go.
And they can't let that incompletion become an uh-oh moment. Like, oh boy, here we go again. Just like last week, each game is its own entity, treated as such.
Good work after the catch gets him 15 and a first down. Now a play fake here on first down.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches. And they're trying
Pike
to create one there. Getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say,
let's get
him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out the zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends.
Oh, man. Since I accepted that penalty, I didn't get my X factor.
On EA Sports. Second quarter about to begin from Denver. It's the Broncos in possession of the football. They'll look to throw here as they've got it with a first and 10. And he'll be taken down at
the 2 yard line.
11 more on that one, and another. Let's go. In the zone.
As a rookie quarterback, that's exactly
how take an extra F.
Give it up for the cause. It's also how you
try and get this drive goal.
Yeah, it's a catch 22. Coach doesn't like it. Teammates love it. Where do you fall on?
Well, I fall on wanting to endear yourself to your teammates, but pick your spots. Be smart. To the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss.
It's TD.
I think quarterbacks gotta see.
What are you doing, bro?
Way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists.
Good stuff, Lindsay.
Into the end zone for a Bronco touchdown.
Good stuff. Alright, going 5 wide. What the heck happened?
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Sliding out of the pocket. And he will be brought down at about the 6 yard line. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Capitalize.
Sometimes you just gotta know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Ballooning the pressure.
Oh! Look at the moves.
Touchdown, Denver. It's their quarterback.
Look at those moves. What I'm talking about. Oh, Lindsay's out there.
They're gonna look to throw. He's got his tight
end, Jake
Bunt, and they work this well upfield across the 45.
Can't be stopped right now.
Remaining in this first half for football. And we remind you, coming up at the half, we'll join who, Charles?
The coach.
The coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores.
What the heck?
As well as scores from earlier today.
So,
we get slap happy up here sometimes. Now here's a pass on first down.
That was weird.
Away and incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You have to think on early downs like
this
down there. Need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
That one again.
Pick some more time off the clock. See how this works. Probably won't.
This first half, not a guy you want to forget. Not only his first catch, first time they targeted it.
That doesn't make any sense, does it? Because those are the types of
and hit behind the line. He lost the
wait. You tell me I wasn't down.
At the 39-yard line.
The previous play, the psychology of the game.
Pretty sure I was down. Yeah, I'm down.
They practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it.
That's my ball. What the heck? Don't think so, Bubba.
After reviewing the play, the line on the field is reversed. So the challenge comes in inside.
And I lost my X.
And it gets overturned.
Sweet.
Touchdown.
Can't stop us in this 5 wide.
He'll look to throw.
Let's go.
Left side, it's reeled in by Hamilton. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get up here for the extra yardage.
Lindsay, man. What are you doing?
And he's dropped on the spot. That's a big time play by the defense.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up.
You got a lot of people on that right side.
Back to throw now on second and 10.
Everything about that play.
Looking for Sam.
And I still threw it over there. What's wrong with me?
Right around the 43. And this one will be returned.
38-yard line.
Face mask. Defense.
Oh, wow. I don't know why they said defense. Got my hopes up.
That's pick, that's pick. tonight. We have more football. Sunday night football, a good one out west. Steelers and Chargers might see equal amounts of black and gold mixed with a powder blue in the stands for that one. And it's no escape, and he goes down. Jarrell Casey with a little how do you do as he
oh, back to firewood.
Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
Now back to throw. They'll roll him out right.
Let's go.
That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Now, that was a whole lot of open space out in front of him, wasn't it? I'm telling you, Brandon, when things are going right, they are going right.
And everything has been going their way for the most part. And I saw that lane start to develop. Boom.
It's a first.
And he'll take it down shy of the 40.
What? Inches? Come on, man.
10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
That's whack.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Ooh. I just want to get around there quicker.
Down, but this time it's incomplete.
It's easy to see when we review this that the ball needs to come out quicker, because if you don't throw it right on the break, you bring a crowd.
There's no way this shouldn't work.
And that's why it got knocked away there. Now it's Lindsay, and he gets this one across midfield for the first down to the 36. Officially a gain of just a yard there, but they do convert on third and inches. In the first half, he was held in check.
Way too close.
Despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Let's go.
They feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from the lead horse, that would open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
That one goes for 20
Same play.
Yards.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in.
Easy. Let's run it.
You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it. I don't know whether I want to be a fly on the wall or not when they hear the
come on, man. You got to get in there.
He, one of the bigger targets on the field, the tight end could be that wide open and uncovered downfield. Who blew that assignment?
Somebody did.
No doubt about it. There's no way you're not going to.
Oh, you went the wrong way.
And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming.
That became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
I only got to throw it.
Steps up here and down.
Sweet.
Cameron Wake. And Denver getting set to take the field.
Good, Lindsay.
Well, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking.
Sanders, you got to give him that lead block, bro.
Situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away. First downs, they can't touch the ball. Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the 4 fingers. Fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the 4 fingers for 4-minute offense.
Look at that, bro. I'm literally in the throwing motion. But it just takes so long to throw the ball in this game. That don't work. It doesn't come out.
Absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
My offensive line is just trash. This trash.
Offense now as they get set to take over here. They can thank their defense for another stop, and now look at the score where they got the football. They're looking pretty good.
They're looking excellent, because now you're thinking to yourself, let's just take some time off the clock, work it down, and of course you put another touchdown on the board. You pretty much say bye bye to this one.
Play calling here can be a little bit more conservative because of the lead.
A little bit more conservative. The biggest thing, everyone understands how to get the ball downfield and how to stay in bounds and make sure the clock keeps running. That would have been real difficult to hold on to it, because
get to the 2-minute warning.
Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
3 yards.
Oh, banged that.
The Broncos offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
And they used it.
Strictly for pride.
Now the Titans will use their third
and sorry, I'm playing stats anyway.
As he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. On first down, right back to Lindsay.
Let's go.
And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a gain of 15, and that ought to just about put an end to this one. I guess he was saving his best for last, so to speak. Longest run of the day coming here in the fourth quarter right there.
And that type of run makes for a better night for him and his teammates, doesn't it?
To be able to let's go.
In the game can lead to some big smiles and satisfaction in the locker room after this one's over.
See if I can't dot up a touchdown.
The Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. That'll leave him with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And he's gonna go down. He sacked back at the 24. Now we'll get whistles.
Yeah, imagine that. I got sacked.
Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
Ah.
That
was plenty of yards. Came back after the worst game. Got a dub. It's nice having Lindsay back. Actually run the ball somewhat.
Thanks for being our quarterback. Yeah, you're the quarterback. Always a pleasure, my friend.
150 rushing yards, let's go.
So for the Broncos, their strong start to the year continues as they're up to 5-1. Home again next week. Meanwhile, for Tennessee, the losses are piling up as they drop to 1-5 now. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home.
It was a pretty good episode so far. Great. I'll take it. See, improviser's an 84. Looks like it's the 85. There's just a running gun. Blitz radar. Gambler. Alrighty. Thanks for watching.